In this video, I am going to talk about the design response spectrum, which is provided in NSAV code in section 208532. I'm going to discuss with you how we can use this tool in the aid of designing irregular structures using Staad software. For irregular structures, you can refer to NSAV section 208.45.2, or you can check table 208-9 and table 208-10 to help you equip in figuring out what irregular structures look like in terms of geometric configuration. Okay, going back to section 208.5.3.2 in NSAV code, it is mentioned here the ground motion representation shall as minimum be one having 10% probability of being exceeded in 50 years. It will not be reduced by quantity R and may be one of the following. So these are the following 5 important items mentioned herein. Item 1, by which we are going to focus on in this video, states that an elastic design response spectrum curve constructed in accordance with figure 208-3. So this item 1 is referring to the design spectrum curve in the said figure. Using values of CE and V consistent with a specific site. So this is telling that the response spectrum provided herein is dependent on these hazard parameters, the CE and CV value, and that these hazard parameters must be the actual value found in the soil investigation and must be consistent in the site where the building you are considering to design shall be constructed. This is referring to the soil type of that site, the seismic type. The design acceleration ordinate shall be multiplied by acceleration of gravity 9.815 meter per second squared. So whatever value we've got here upon calculation must be multiplied by value 9.81. So the use of the design response spectrum curve provided herein in the figure 208-3 has a design level of 10% probability of being exceeded in 50 years. Meaning to say, 90% chance that this peak ground acceleration that we are using in this response spectrum may not be exceeded in the next 50 years, where this level of earthquake force corresponds to a return period of 475 years. And most building codes use this level of earthquake force as the design-based earthquake. So this is our goal in this video, to use this response spectra provided by this code. And in order to use this tool, we must first take a look at the three parts of this graph. This line here is the part 1, and from the origin to point TO. The equation of this line is not replicated here. So we have to derive this equation of this line in this part so we can use this in the design of the structure. Otherwise, we won't be able to get acceleration value once this time period falls into this area. The second part is from TO to TS, which is the horizontal line. And the equation of this line is evident from here. And it is SA is equal to 2.5 CE. The next part, which is the third part, is a curve. And the equation of this curve is obviously SA is equal to CB divided by T, where T is the time period. And it is already written here. CE and CB values can be obtained from table 208-7 and 208-8 respectively in NSAV. And you can see there that CE is a function of NA while CB is a function of NB, and both are John factor dependent. Now let us come to derive first this line equation. So we first identify the two known points that lie within this line. Answer the line that are under consideration. Point 1 coordinates 0 CE. So this is E1 is equal to 0 and T1 is equal to CE. And the point 2 coordinates are TO and 2.5 CE. Meaning to say, is E2 is equal to TO and T2 is equal to 2.5 CE. I'm sorry, this is wrong. So from a very familiar two-point form equation of determining equation of a line in a Cartesian plane, so having this x and y axis, we say that y minus y sub 1 is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1, open parenthesis, times x minus x sub 1. Since y-axis is represented by is A, and the x-axis is represented by T, then we change y and x to is A and T respectively. So, is A minus is A1 is equal to is A2 minus is A1 divided by T2 minus T1. And then multiplied by T minus T1. And here, is E minus CE is equal to 2.5 CE minus CE divided by TO minus 0, then T minus 0. Then, is E is equal to 1.5 CE divided by TO times T plus CE. And here, is E minus CE is equal to 2.5 CE minus CE divided by TO minus 0, then T minus 0. Then, is E is equal to 1.5 CE divided by TO times T plus CE. And then, is E is equal to 1.5 CE divided by 0.2 TS. So, we substitute the value TO in here. TO now becomes 0.2 TS. Then times T plus CE. Substituting this equation to here. So, SE is equal to 18.75 CS squared over CB times T plus CE. So, this is now the equation of this line. Then, number 2, we have already SE is equal to 2.5 CE. So this is line 2. And 3, we have SE is equal to CB over T, the curve. So after going through this, we are going to assume CE and CB values. So, and assuming our swivel profile type is SD, where the shear velocity of this type of swivel ranges from 180 to 360 meters per second, with undrained swivel strength ranges from 50 to 100 kilopascal. My CV value is right down here. Our seismic source type is V, with NA and NB value both equal to 1, which can be found here. So, from those informations, our value for CE is equal to 0.44 and our CB is equal to 0.64. Now you might be wondering, what is this TS and TO equations used for in this graph? Well, TO is the upper limit of this line 1, and TS on the other side is the upper limit of this horizontal line. So what does it mean? First, we calculate TO and TS. Second is, we compare the natural time period of a mood shift to this TO value. If the period is less than this TO, then spectral acceleration response is calculated in this line. Otherwise, calculated from this next line. If the time period is greater than or equal to TO and less than TS, then spectral acceleration is calculated based on this line. Unless otherwise, then the spectral acceleration is obtained from this curve. Next is, we are going to select points from 0 to, let's say, 10 seconds in this axis. If we intend to design low-rise structure, or shall we say, two-story building, then most likely the estimated time period of vibration of such structure does not exceed 1 second. Otherwise, using higher time period up to 10 seconds is much better, and there is no problem with it. So in here, in this Excel sheet, I randomly pick points from here up to here. So from low to higher time period, arranged in an orderly manner as shown in here. So makikita natin, from low to high yan. Then the next is, we are going to calculate the corresponding acceleration. So it is shown here. So to automate the calculation of the spectral acceleration, then we use this Excel sheet, so that every time we change the CE and CB value, then the spectral acceleration is automatically calculated without any hassle. By the way, what is the time period by structure? If I have a structure herein, and I'm going to apply force in this direction, the structure will respond to the force applied and will experience a pre-vibration mode. As it vibrates, the time it takes for a structure to complete a revolution is called the time period. And this time period is dependent on the mass and stiffness of the structure. Meaning to say, light structure vibrates faster than heavy structure. Short buildings vibrate faster than tall buildings. I'm going to highlight and copy this file and paste into Notepad to further arrange into a format such that Staad software can read and interpret. So from here, we are going to arrange this by fur. So this is one fur. Add semicolon. Semicolon. Like that. Again, this is semicolon. This pair of number should be arranged like this. 0.001 space 4.316, then semicolon. So take note of one space here. Leave no space after semicolon. So no space. Like that. Then again, one space. So let's go to Staad file. We are going to prepare that file. In here, I have here load case detail, axegdll, then wind load. So here I am going to add two load cases. Add one, this is Rx, meaning to say response spectrum along X. Then click add RG. Then click add. Then from here, I'm going to add this is Rx. Let's add response spectra. Now I'm going to use custom. Then CQC. Since this is response spectrum along X, let us check this directional factor X. Then just type 1 momentarily. Then add. Then click OK. Another one here in RG. Again, response spectra, add, custom, then CQC. Then since this is along G, we are going to uncheck X and check G. Then type 1 for the meantime. Then no data in the spectrum table. Click OK. Let us open the command file. So scroll down. Now these two load cases, load 8 and 9, were the load cases that we had just created a while ago. So if you can remember here. Now what we gonna do here, we are going to bring here our file which we created in Notepad. Just simply copy and paste into this editor. So highlight this one and copy. Then go back to Staad editor, then paste like that. Then also here from RG, paste, then close and yes, save changes. If we come back here and see what we've got, yeah, response spectrum is now here. For response spectrum along J, if you notice, the first time period is 0 and the corresponding acceleration is 4.316 meter per second squared. Second is 0.029 and the acceleration is 5.935. And if we check our Excel file, what is in here must be in the Excel file. In the next video, I am going to give a sample file, this file, and discuss how to design this file using response spectrum analysis. So guys, sa mga bago lang, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for you to be always updated. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.